Lesson 4-5 deals with using similar figures. Yesterday we learned how, in the last lesson, we learned about similar figures and how to identify whether or not they were similar figures. And today we're going to say, okay, now that we know what a similar figure is, how can we use it? First, we need to learn our new definitions for this lesson. An indirect measurement is a technique of using similar figures and proportions to find a measure. And we got this pretty little set of drawings here, and it says find the unknown measures in the similar figures. And you can see that right over here you have an X. Guess what? We have to find out what X is equal to, and that really isn't going to be very hard to do at all. We already know all the tools we need to do it. First thing we're going to do is we're going to write a proportion using corresponding sides. And you can see that in doing that, I've got side AB, that is this side right here, corresponds to side JG, this side right here. And side BC, this one here, corresponds to side HG, this one's here. How did I know that? Well, I just kind of looked at it and I saw what they would correspond to. Now you'll notice that I did not use the hypotenuse, the longest side of the right triangle. I did not use that side or this side. I could have. Just chose not to. Why did I choose not to? Well, BC, BA, and JG are all whole numbers. These sides, you got 11.6 and 5.8. I'd rather deal with whole numbers than decimals. So if you have a choice, you probably want to go for those whole numbers and use them because they'll be a lot easier to work with. Now that we've got our proportions set up showing whether or what they are, we're going to take and fill each of these values in. AB, you see right here, is 10 centimeters. JG, right here, is 5 centimeters. BC, 6 centimeters. And HG is our unknown, our X value. Now this should look very familiar to you. We've worked problems like this for a couple days during this lesson, and you've got a ratio of 10 to 5 compared to a ratio of 6x. We know that they're proportional because we've been told that yes, these are similar figures, so how are we going to solve them? Well, of course, the way we get that, find out what this X is we start by cross multiplying up! And when we do that, you get 10 times X and 5 times 6. Remember, you got X times 10 gave us this 10 net times X here, and then the 5 times 6 gave us this value right here. That, of course, leaves us with 10X, and 5 times 6 is 30. Of course, from here, we've got that pretty little equation. The final goal of any equation is to isolate our variable. The variable is X. His friend is 10. 10 is multiplying itself by X, so to isolate the variable, we're going to take and divide both sides by the 10. So you got 10x divided by 10 and 30 divided by 10. The 10s on the left cancel each other out, leaving X is equal to 3 for our final answer. So how long is side HG? Side HG, this side length right here, is going to be 3 centimeters. Real easy to do. We can also use similar figures to find out the size of missing angles. If you recall, we've been taught that the corresponding angles in a similar figures are also going to be congruent or equal to each other. So when we look at these two figures, we can say, well, first we need to find y. That's what it's asking for right here. We've got to find the value of that y. So we're going to say that the angle, this little thingy right here, means angle. Angle H, that's Y's angle right there, corresponds to what angle? It corresponds to angle C right here. Angle C has a measurement of 59 degrees. Therefore, angle Y has a measurement of 59 degrees. Corresponding angles have congruent measurements, or they're the same measurement. Easy math. And, of course, you want to circle or box that answer. Now you take and try this one. Find the unknown measurements in the similar figures. Notice you've got two measurements you've got to find. You've got to find the Y for the angle there, and you've got to find the X for the missing side length. Take yourself some time, get it started, pause recording while you're doing it, and then we'll find the or compare answers in just a minute. All right, hopefully you paused the recording. Let's go ahead and take a look at it and see what you came up with and compare your work with mine and your answers with mine. First off, we had to write a proportion using corresponding sides. I chose to use sides AB right here and side FD right here as my corresponding sides. That last one is not correct. So let me see if I can undo that. It's gone. Side FE. Yeah, that's right. We don't want to use decimals if we can avoid it as my corresponding sides. And we've got side BC right here and side DE right there. Now all we have to do is plug in the number values for each of these, which gives you 4/7 is equal to 9x. And from there you're going to cross multiply. There you go. Cross multiply up, which is going to end up giving you 4 times x on the left and 9 times 7 on the right. Of course, 14 times x is 14x, and 9 times 7 is 63. That gives you your equation. Just got to isolate your variable, dividing both sides by the 14. The 14s on the left cancel each other out, and 14 goes into 63 4.5 times. Let's take a look at how we got that 4.5. The first number always goes in the house, so we got 14 going into 63. 14 went into 6 4 times, which ended up giving me a 6 here and then a 4 or 5, and that's going to give me 7 left over. Annex in a decimal and a 0, the decimal went up, the 0 went down, and 14 went into 70 5 times, which gave us 70 with nothing left over. That's where we got the 4.5 for our final answer, and of course we want to take and circle or box it, and we can say that 4.5 is the length of this side right here, 4.5 centimeters. Now we also need to go from here and solve for the Y value. So to find the Y value, we're going to say, well, angle D, which is the one that Y corresponds to here, and my thing's locked up. There, it's working now. Angle D corresponds to the Y, and angle C corresponds to 63. Now, there's a way that you could write this. You could say that angle D is congruent to angle C. Anytime you have two equal signs with a squiggly, that means that they're congruent or they correspond to each other here. That way you can avoid writing these big words. You can just write equals with a squiggly. It means the same thing. Of course, angle C is equal to 63 degrees. Therefore, we can say that angle D, also known as Y, is also equal to 63 degrees for our boxed final answer. Easy math. All right, try your hand at this one. It says the rectangle to the left is similar in shape to the rectangle at right. Right there, it's telling us, hey guys, these are similar figures. That means the side lengths must be corresponding. Find the width of the right rectangle. In other words, find this value here. I think you've got enough knowledge to do this, so go ahead and pause the recording and work on it. All right, let's see what you did. You've got to set up your corresponding sides, and we're going to let W be the width of the right triangle. And that gave us a proportion that said that 6 centimeters is to 12 centimeters as 3 centimeters is to W. Now we need to make sure that if the pink one here is the bottom on this side, it needs to be the bottom there. If the purple rectangle is the top on this side, it has to be the top there. From here you got 6 twelfths equals 3W. Of course we're going to cross multiply up from this point, which is going to give me 6 times W on the left, because we went up like that, and 12 times 3 on the right. That will give me 6W is equal to 36, divide both sides by 6 to isolate our variable. These 6's here say bye-bye. They're going to cancel each other out, which is going to end up leaving me with W is equal to 6 for my final answer. So the rectangle, the right rectangle, this side length right here, is going to be 6 centimeters wide. Easy math. Now here's a real world application for this. City officials want to know the height of a traffic light, and they're going to estimate the height of the traffic light based off the known height of the stop sign. See, they could reach the top of the stop sign, and they know that that stop sign is going to be 15 feet tall. So what they're going to do is they're going to create a point right here where they can draw that straight line going across the top of the stop sign and across the top of the stop light. And what they've created is two triangles. You've got this triangle for that one, and you've got this triangle for this one. You have two similar triangles here. You've got corresponding base lengths of 27.25 and 48.75, and you know what one of the heights is, 15 feet. We've just got to solve for the other one right here. So let's work on doing that. We're going to take and write a proportion, and this time they took their bottoms, their 27.25 and the 48.75, and put them on the top here. They put the heights and put them on the bottom. The height of the, remember, the height of the stop sign had this corresponding with the length there, so the 15 and the 27.25 had to be together, and then the height of the stoplight had to correspond with the length of the distance to it. To find your cross products. Actually, no, they said, hold on, they said to estimate. Oh, that makes this a whole lot easier. Looky, estimate. That means that we can find numbers that are friendly with each other, that get along nice, using compatible numbers. You don't even have to round these things to the nearest number. You can just find friendly, very close, compatible numbers. So the 27.25, let's make that 25. The 15, we're going to leave alone. And the 48.75, we're going to make that 50. From here, they're going to take and find your cross products. Nope, we're not either. We're going to simplify. 25 15ths became 5 thirds. Simplify those two. Now maybe, yep, now they found the cross product. 3 times 50 gave you the 150, and the h times 5 gave you the 5h. 5 times h is about 150. Let's talk about that. See the squiggly equal sign here? Notice it had been a real equal, and then it became a squiggly because we're no longer using precise numbers. Now we're using numbers that are close, that are estimated. Let's go ahead and isolate our variable down here on the bottom now. Divide both sides by 5, and when we do, we find that h is about 30. So the height of that stoplight is going to be about 30 feet off the ground. Your assignment to go with this lesson is going to be page 170, numbers 1 through 16 odd.
I listen closely for the choir.